I'll tell you, back before our time, before my time even, there was an agent in New York called Charlie Rapp. And Charlie Rapp would send his in Manhattan, he'd send his comics out to upstate New York, up in the Catskills and work up there. And when the comics got up there, they'd finish the gig. They would never come back to New York. They'd call and see if there might be more work on the road while they're out there. So in those days, they called on a person to person. See, that way it didn't cost any money. They would call Charlie Rapp, and they'd call person to person in their own name. You know, and then they would say, you know, operator would say, I have a person-to-person phone call from a Jackie Jensen. And Charlie would say, Jackie's not here, operator, but he's at the Buffalo Hyatt House next Friday and Saturday. and this is the money. And he's in room 475. That's the money, right? So this is supposedly a true story. The guy called, and he said, Charlie Rapp Agency. The operator said, I have a collect call here for you, Jackie Jensen. Operator, Jackie's not here, but he'd be at the Syracuse Hyatt House next Friday and Saturday, and he's in room 250. And the comic said, operator, see if you can get him in room 450 or 500. Yeah. Charlie, operator, tell him he's lucky he's even in the hotel. Well, you guys all know this, but it's the typical story of comics. I mean, we all know it, and so I was repeating, but for those who maybe not heard this, but it's the greatest comedian story, and you guys will get it more than civilians will. But the comic who's at Caesar's Palace in Vegas, and he's sound asleep. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. The phone rings, and he goes, "Hello," and a woman said, "I saw your show tonight, and I want to come to your room, and I want to do things to your body that no woman has ever done before." And he said, did you see the first show or the second show? You see, we don't care about the sex thing. We were better. One show was a little bit better than the other show, you know.